part of the goal of graduate school is to take someone who's already aiming high, and we want you to, you know, walk in the door clear that this is a build your own adventure. There is a safe space waiting for you. There is a career laboratory. There really is the opportunity to build your own adventure.
I had zero previous exposure to many of the business foundation concepts that we, mm-hmm. you know, that we got in our core.
I think the first thing that's very misleading is that I was confident in this entire process. That's absolutely not true. I had many doubts the entire time, and you're never gonna know if it's the right decision or not until, like, maybe hindsight.
Pre-MBA, I was a French major working for an engineering firm, and I thought I was dumb because I'm not an engineer and it's not how I think.
I am from China, so I was born and raised in a very distant small town in China. It's like I know everyone from my class, from my kindergarten to my high school. That's how tight the town is.
You come to a new environment like Anderson and you realize how not diverse some of your previous experiences may have been, and that's kind of how it happened for me. The combat arms units I served with were all male units, so you know now we're immediately taking another huge chunk of the population that I just didn't have professional experience working alongside.
I knew that it would give me a perspective and a set of experience that I couldn't have exclusively working.
I went to Anderson, I was a career explorer, did not know what I wanted to do. I knew I wanted to do something great. I wanted to be a CEO and I wanted to be a philanthropist and I had no idea how to get there. And I thought an MBA is gonna open up the doors. It's gonna give me that business background that's going to be applicable to any job, any business area, any industry.
I learned so much every time they put on an Ask Me Anything panel for LGBTQ Awareness Week. I went to the Velocity Conference in my last year, you know, just tagging along with the Black Business Students Association when they set up a volunteering event at a high school here in LA. All of those things kind of like brought something new and helped me enjoy my time at Anderson more.
Going into the FEMBA program, I never once thought I was going to be coming out with a finance specialization. So I told the kids, I'm like, yeah, your mommy's done with school, finally. And my daughter's like, I'm so proud of you, mommy. And I'm like, thank you. You know, and she's like, no, mommy, but really. And then she just hugs me and both the kids hug me. And I'm like, I'm not crying right now. I'm not going to cry right now.
What would now Tina tell then Tina?
Do what you can to prepare, but also you'll never be prepared enough.
Go all in. You're going to fall. You're going to get hurt. Get up, brush yourself off and do it again. And help each other along the way.
I think if you come from a background or industry that is not diverse from a race, gender, or identity perspective, and you know, Anderson shows that too, you have an opportunity, and it's a critical part of the Anderson experience to kind of, you know, expose yourself and address that gap.
It's okay when you don't know what you want to do, to be honest. I would say, like, a lot of people who came to Anderson is with the mission they want to find out what they want to do.
And you might find, like I did at Anderson, I love global macroeconomics, I love finance, but I just hadn't been exposed to it. Life is a journey and you continue to learn. Anderson gives you a great foundation, but the learning doesn't stop there. What I've personally learned is I don't have to have all the answers to accomplish that goal if you continue to move towards it. And I feel like anyone can do that. Just know that you're gonna learn along the way. You don't have to have it figured out to get started.
The plan doesn't have to be great, but there was a plan in there somewhere.
Oh, and my God, that may be the headline of your podcast. The plan doesn't have to be great, but there was a plan.
At Anderson, if you're like me and you realize you have a surface level understanding of some different things, industries or coursework or whatever, you have the experts to reach out to. So ask your friend or fellow FEMBA. They're the people I would go to, both for guidance and future career decisions. FEMBA allows you to be around those people and those experts all the time.
And I measure the ROI not by anything that I've achieved, but on looking back at my career thus far and knowing that everywhere I've been able to add value and unlock my own opportunity.
You can get an MBA from really anywhere, you know, like the degree is the degree. But what do you get at Anderson? What do you get at UCLA? It's so much more than just the degree. It's the network, the community, there's so many other aspects of it that really make this one a very special, I would say, decision.
3 years later, I'm so proud of myself to graduate from Anderson, to be honest. I can say this is one of the best decisions I've made.